Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. So in this video, I'll be talking about some of the highest paying part-time jobs in the United Kingdom. As most of you will be coming in the UK, so I thought like this video is like must show that I share this knowledge with my own audience. Without any further ado, I'll just get started with this video. The very first job on the list which I've got is of content creator or web designer and developers. And moreover, like all of the part-time jobs which I'll be highlighting in this video, you might need certain skills because these are the high paying part-time jobs, so you might need some prior knowledge about all of these things. The first one, as I said, is the content creator or the web designer. Now, recently in my own university, so it's called University of Strathclyde, and I went to their like the online job market, and I found this vacancy of content creator, and for per hour they were paying £45, which is a huge amount to really pay per hour basis. And secondly, it is not just like one of the instances where I saw that £45. Moreover, there are something called on-campus brand ambassadors. So for them, what you need to do is you just need to make a video for the brands which you'll be working with. You need to produce more of the content, and the wage which you can expect is around £10 or £12 every single hour, and it will be a 20-hour job. And all of these jobs you can find within your university. So the first thing, which was the content creator, and the second is called web designer. Now, for the web designer, it's about designing and developing a range of websites. I'm looking at my left because I've got all of this point listed out there so that don't miss them. And so basically, if you've got some knowledge of the web designer, if you know that of the skill, that how you need to build a website, how do you need to build an application, again, this is a very lucrative job. And per hour basis, you can expect to earn about £25. Usually, the companies look for like full-time workers for this all work, but there are some of the small scale companies, small firms, which look for like part-time workers as well. So that's why the very first job on the list is called web designer, developer, or the content creation field. In the second part-time job on the list which I've got is for social care. Now, well, when I was staying in the Newcastle, when I was doing my placement, there was one of my friend, he used to actually work in the social care. And well, it can sometimes be very hard when you're working in this industry because you're taking care of some of the old people. Few of them might be mentally unstable, so it can be a little bit challenging job, but in terms of the wage rate, it has got a really strong wage. So per hour basis, you can expect to earn about £28 every single hour. So this is a really amazing amount. And moreover, in terms of the hours, I think you can get 20 hours pretty much easily, as we've got restrictions, so the maximum limit is 20 hours, and I anticipate that we'll be getting 20 hours. Now, in order to work in the social care, most of them, in order to get a job, go on Indeed website and you can get a work in the social care. Basically, it will be a company, so company will be hiring, let's say it's a full organization, it will be hiring about 5 or 6 different employees, and there's a house, there's some like old people, he wants to take care of himself, their like children might be contacting you. Well, you know, we have got our father in our home, he's like 60 years old, 70 years old, can you take over help? And that guy will be contacting the company and they will be sending you one of the employees which they have hired to that particular place. So you can expect that it could be like every single week you might be going in one house and in the second or in the third, or otherwise it could be the same person for your, let's say, entire week. So this is like some of the experience which I got from the friend which I was talking to, and you can expect to earn about £28 every single hour in the UK in the social care industry. And the third part-time job on the list is of the waiting staff. Now, well, I mean, like this job, like most of the students are employed in the hospitality sector when they come to the UK, and waiting staff is one of the kind of the best job to really go for, because I mean, if you don't have that much of the previous skills, but you are a friendly person, you know how to kind of communicate with the other person, you can really still come into this waiting industry as well. And in terms of the wage rate, they've got a very strong wage rate. You can at least expect to earn your national living wage, which is about £9. Now, sometimes it can depend upon which restaurant you work in. If you're working in a desi Indian restaurant, it might be a little bit challenging, but still I will say that they will be at least paying you the national minimum wage, which kind of depends upon your age category. In order to watch that video, that what is the national minimum wage, I'll be mentioning a video in the I button which you can watch after this video. So waiting staff is something which you can really look for, and the thing, and in order to apply for the waiting staff job, most of the restaurant, especially in the coronavirus pandemic, right after, when now once the lockdown is all opened, whenever I go outside in the city center, I can see they've put all the stickers, help wanted, we need a worker, we need a worker, we need a worker. So it's everywhere around. So I think people who are coming in like September intake, January intake, I think they can easily get a job, at least in the waiting staff industry, because most of the restaurant wants staff now. So, and again, I've already explained you the wage rate, and all you need to do is in terms of your application, just make sure that you've got a CV made just for some of the experience which you had in the India, right? So when you're in the India, like let's say like for at least about a week or 2 weeks, just work in a bakery store, work in a like a small restaurant, your friend's restaurant somewhere, just work, just gather some experience so that you can put that in your CV and you can actually learn something from that and then apply in the restaurant where you'll be working in. And the number fourth, a job on the list which I've got is for a content. Again, this is a really great job, and on per hour basis you can expect to earn £15 to £20. Now basically in terms of this job, again, this is mainly the bigger companies kind of hire accountant, usually the roles are full-time. However, as I so basically I'm everything which I'm talking this video, I'm referencing from read.co.uk, and as they said, even there are some of the smaller organizations which again wants to hire accountant because they want to keep track for their accountant. Because I remember there used to be like one of my friend used to work in a restaurant, and the restaurant people had actually hired a part-time accountant because he used to take care of the cash settling and all that process of that, all the Excel sheet, all that data. In order to record that, they had a separate accountant in order to take his help for the content for that particular firm or that restaurant where that guy used to work in. And the in order to, for skills, what kind of skills do you need for this job? You need to have excellent math skills, you need a natural aptitude for numbers, and necessarily you don't need a degree, that you need accountancy degree. However, if you're strong in this like math skills and in your if you have like aptitude for numbers, then yes, you can really get a job as an accountant. The secondly, the important thing is that you need to be having a knowledge for the accounting software as well, you know. So there are, I'm not in this field, but there's some of the accounting software which you need to really have a knowledge about in order to go in this industry. And the another thing which I want to mention over here is that something is called AAT qualification. So if you want to work in an accountancy industry, I think AAT qualification is something which will be very valuable, which you can really look forward to and research more on this. And for the wage rate, as I said, it's about £15 to £20 every single hour. And the number fifth and the last one on the list which I've got is hair and beauty. Again, here you really need to have some prior experience. So when you're in India, so try to work in a salon or try to work in a hairdresser shop or something, because once you learn that skill, you know, you can really apply when you're in the UK. So here you can work as like a makeup artist, you can work as a massage therapist, because I see plenty of massage centers in the city center, right? So if you have got that skills, you can really apply over here. You can become a beauty therapist. And moreover, like sometime I don't see there's so much of a difference girls boys thing, but if there are girls who like or even boys as well who really don't want to do high lifting jobs, so well, you can learn this skill such as hair and beauty. Really don't have to do much of a heavy work, you know that skill, and you can really apply and do these kind of jobs as well when you are in the UK. And again, the wage rate is very strong. You can expect to earn around £15 every single hour in the hair and beauty industry. And the another thing which they have written is that the hair and beauty industry is highly competitive. Blogging about your experience is a great way to get your personality and your expertise across to the potential interviewers and the clients. So just be passionate about all these things. So by that, what they mean is that, let's say, basically write on Quora, like let's say have your Instagram page where you're putting that, you know, I've done this kind of makeup, so that you can really make your portfolio very strong, right? So at the end of the day, for example, if I was talking about the content creation, I was talking about the web developers, you need to have your online portfolios for all of these things, that where you have done this work previously. So these are the some of the jobs which I really wanted to highlight in this video. Again, I could make a second part of this video if you would like to comment in the description box below. I can make a second part. And thanks for your time for watching this video. I hope you got some value, and this is a video which I'll be suggesting you to watch next. And also subscribe to the channel for regular updates. Cheers, thank you very much.